Tylee, we've talked a lot about you going out on top. How does it feel now that you did it?
I was telling them earlier today that I wasn't as nervous for this game, I think, as all the other games, because I knew that this was going to be, you know, the last time I was able to play with these girls. So to be able to, you know, end on a win at home, I couldn't have asked for a better ending.
Myah, how do you feel, you know, winning the championship?
Yeah, absolutely. Same.
Can't really write it any better. We got to stay at home, do it in front of Jackrabbit Nation. That's just been great all year, but just got bigger and better throughout this tournament. And to send our seniors out with a win, not many programs get to do that. And to do it at home is even better.
Kallie, when they switched to that zone, it seemed like you found a lot of space down low. What were you seeing out there that led to your big night?
Yeah, definitely. We obviously have a lot of players on our team who can make plays. So I think they had trouble guarding that a little bit. So I was able to find some gaps, and we just got the ball in the right places.
Kallie, was rebounding something you guys came into this game thinking you guys could kind of dominate? Because it's what you guys did the whole game.
Yeah, definitely. I think we try to emphasize rebounding every single game. And this game, obviously, it paid off. We knew we had to crash low boards and make sure we were boxing out. And we ended up doing a really good job of that.
Tylee, you've been in the NCAA tournament. You went to the Sweet 16. I don't know if you can compare them at all, but you know, what where does this run rank, you know, in your career?
It's really hard to compare, to be honest. Yeah. But I just can't imagine, you know, wanting to be anywhere else than I am right now. I have no regrets, you know, about that at all.
Yeah.
Myah, you always give a lot of credit to your teammates, but obviously winning the MVP of a tournament on a national stage like that had to be pretty cool. What are your feelings on that?
Yeah, it's special, but I think what makes it special is just this year having my teammates by my side. You know, this year has been a tough year, especially, you know, coming off of how last year ended. And so it's been a journey this year, and to have the support of my teammates, the coaching staff, means the world to me. And so just really special.
And for any of you, how about a freshman, Haley Timmer, making the all-tournament team?
That girl.
Timmy doesn't know she's a freshman.
No, definitely
she's
not.
Got no fear. And it's going to be so fun to watch her in these next few years and see what she can accomplish.
Well, congratulations to our team. What a wonderful accomplishment, you know, to be in this tournament, to be in this environment, and have the crowds that we've had over the past several weeks, to be here to share that experience with family, friends, donors, supporters, longtime season ticket holders. It's an unbelievable feeling. I just couldn't be happier for our team to be in this position. We beat a good team. Seton Hall was very deserving of being here. We just played very, very well. I think they missed some shots early and just never got themselves going offensively. But I thought our effort defensively was really good. How we rebounded the ball was really good. And just couldn't be happier for our team getting to experience this at home. You know, we really tried to focus on X's and O's and playing well, but we really talked a lot about make sure we, out on the floor, bring out the best in each other. How do we lift each other up to be the best version of ourselves, whether it's players or coaches?
Everything you guys have gone through this season, you know, how good is it feel to finish off with a win?
You know, it's amazing. You know, it really is. This has been an event that I think people will remember. Having it here on campus makes it feel so personal. It is something that our seniors will take with them to the rest of their, you know, days here as they think back to what SDSU is all about. It's just a remarkable feeling to be able to do this at home and get a win to finish it off.
I think allowed you guys to get off to such a quick start there in the first quarter?
You know, I think we've really played well here. Quite honestly, I thought the UCLA game, we played really well, just didn't get into a flow offensively. But our defense and rebounding has been fantastic throughout the tournament. So we defended and rebounded well, and then we just made some shots early. Everybody really settled in, played with confidence, I thought, in those first few minutes, and that just carried through the rest of the game.
As I rebounded them by 25, you know, what do you think? Seems like these past few games, the teams have kind of maybe been bigger down low, but you guys have had success rebounding.
Yeah, we've really done a great job on the glass. Kallie Theisen off the bench today was just a machine. It seemed like she got every rebound that came close to her. Myah was great. Our guards rebounded really well. The only way you can rebound well is if you defend well. You know, if you're taken out of the net all the time, you're not getting any rebounds. So our defense really set the tone, but then we did rebound on both sides, offensively and defensively, really well.
What do you think, obviously the game was well in hand at this point, but you guys kept adding to the lead until midway through the fourth quarter. How much do you think that kind of exemplifies how much your team wanted it?
Yeah, I thought we were highly motivated and driven from the beginning. You know, we just had a great edge about us, a great energy. I thought the fans really contributed to that. What a great environment to play in for our team. I know it's incredibly difficult for our opponents, but what a great environment to showcase, I think, women's basketball at a really high level. And so our team just stayed focused throughout that game. You know, we were really driven defensively. Offensively, we had some ups and downs, but our defense was just so good, we never let them make a run to get back in it.
You've talked about her a lot this postseason, but Haley Timmer had another solid game today. Do you think what she's done has been as much about kind of the opportunity that she's gotten when inserted into the starting lineup, or how would you assess that?
Yeah, I think Haley Timmer, you know, her run here in the postseason is one that'll be a great springboard for her going forward for our team. But I absolutely believe it has a lot to do with just the opportunity. You know, we went to a different lineup there in the postseason and moved her in the starting spot. Earlier in the year, she'd been playing a little bit behind Tylee, behind Tori, and you know, I think rightfully so. Those are two elite players too. But this really allowed, I think, Haley Timmer to shine. And she was a difference maker. She wasn't a good freshman. She was one of the better perimeter players that, you know, we saw in all the games that we played. So happy for her and excited to see where she takes it from here.
We talk about her a lot, but Myah Selland, you know, had a six-game run there. There's a reason she was MVP. I mean, she rightfully deserved that.
Yeah, we should talk about Myah Selland a lot. She's that good a player. She's that good a teammate. She's a great leader, captain. You know, our team focused on trying to bring out the best of each other, and that's who Myah is. As good as she is as a player, she's a phenomenal leader. She's someone that gets everybody else kind of coming in the right direction, keeps them there, and no question, she's going to be special here as she goes forward.
About Tylee Irwin, just as a, you know, just as a career that she had and the opportunity to go out like she did today.
Yeah, I'm happy for all of our seniors. Tylee has had such a huge impact on our program now, 5 years. She started a ton of games. She's been in a lot of big games. She's had to battle through injuries, you know, some tough losses, some big wins. She's been about as consistent of a person and a teammate as anybody could ever expect or hope for. It'll be a big hole losing Tylee. I know a lot of people have said already, it's only been minutes since the game is over, boy, you're just excited for next year. And in my mind, I'm thinking, how do we fill the role, you know, that Tylee played for us? Because I think it's incredibly undervalued, and it's going to be a big loss.
Aaron, you've had teams before that were in this tournament that were good enough to win this tournament, but they didn't. Was there something different about this year's team, just their buy-in or whatever, that allowed them to do what those other teams couldn't quite do?
Yeah, I think certainly playing at home is a huge advantage. We recognize that. Our other teams were in this event, eventually went on the road, and eventually lost close games to good teams. So being at home was a huge part of it. And our fans were amazing. I mean, just amazing. When you can't communicate on the floor, that's loud, right? When people can't hear you 10 feet away from you, that is really loud. And I think our players maybe appreciate some of that coming from me on the sideline at times, but that advantage is remarkable. And then I think the other thing that we really did is this team just valued each other so much. And I know every team says we're family and we do all that stuff. This team absolutely brought out the best of each other. And I think when they got into March here, we got over a disappointment of a loss in the conference tournament. And instead of, you know, sulking and pouting about it, they just lifted each other up. And I think every time we took the floor in this tournament, our team was focused on bringing out the best of one another.
Every time a team is in the NIT or wins the NIT, people ask them to compare that to an NCAA tournament, you know, whatever. But I wanted to ask you, how does this compare to winning a Division II national championship? 20 years ago, you did that. Are there some similarities there, maybe, to making that run and winning that championship to how you're feeling right now?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, this is a national championship, and that's the way it should be looked at. It's a different tournament than the NCAA tournament, but it's a national championship. We started off with a group of schools that are all collectively fairly similar, you know. There was no easy wins. We had some scores that looked good, but there were no easy opponents coming through this. To get to this point, we got to win 6 games. We had to go through Power 5 schools that I'm sure thought, hey, we should be an NCAA tournament team. Our team played really well here every single game to get to this point. So it absolutely feels like, you know, winning a national championship like our Division II. You know, I get to the point where I never compare one is better or, you know, that I'd never do. But it feels like that, and it should feel like that for those young women. I hope they embrace it that same way. I know our fans did. It is so special for them to be a part of this, which many of them don't get to do if you're in the NCAA tournament. So there's other valuable things that we get in this event that we probably don't in a lot of other ones.